Hi, I'm Cyaneink, and today I'm going to try out the new series, which is called Phantom Pen Problems. Because today I actually encountered problem with my Phantom Pen. And this is pen BBS 309 Phantom Pen, which is piston filler. And as you can see, it's running low of ink. And I was going like, because when I run low of ink, I usually like squeeze out the rest of the ink into the section and make it a couple of more lines out of it, but as you can see, when I try to turn the piston, can you see what happens here? Piston is stuck. It's piston is not moving. The part that is moving is the turning knob, and it's like, and seal is actually not moving. It's rotating there. You can see that this part here starts to rotate, and it's not moving. Piston is stuck. This is really annoying problem, and I actually first gonna tell why it's happening. It's happening because lack of lubrication between piston seal and the barrel. And this is pretty new Phantom Pen, so I'm pretty bummed about that. But let's try. One thing is like disassemble the whole pen here. When I disassemble the piston, this is like I haven't been disassembling this pen before, so I'm really closely looking how these threads go here. I can see there's a slight gap, and take like mental note or take like physical note if you want how the piston rod is in the pen, because that will be helpful when you are assembling it, because you may need some fiddling around. I think the Wispy pens are a bit easier because they're so well like documented, but this one is from Ben BBS and they don't have documentation about that. Oh! Yeah, here you can see that I started to screw it down and piston started moving. So I'm not disassembling the whole pen. I'm actually pulling the piston back up. Yeah, I have to disassemble the whole piston unit because now you can see what happens. I'm pulling the piston back up and I'm left by this gap here. I actually always like tight it. Yeah, it starts to rotate. Yeah. Now it's working up and down. Sometimes it takes some little fiddling, and with modern pens it's not so big deal because you can like rotate it up and down. Be really careful here, I'm worried that my piston may drop down. Because you can rotate this and it's like plastic that is sturdy and stuff. But be very, very gentle. If you feel like any resistance and or something that's like that piston is not moving, I strongly suggest that you like stop there, because it may be a sign that the threads are not working properly. But yeah, sometimes it's help like clean the pen and then work piston up and down really slowly and gently. If it isn't moving like up and down, then you have to disassemble the whole pen, but that's really, it depends about the pen. One thing you also can do is like soak the pen, but I know it's not dried up in here. But now I'm going to show how you can lubricate this piston here. I'm really thinking, should I take this apart or not? I think I will go like disassemble this whole pen, because I have feeling it may do that again. So I'm screwing the piston out, and then the back tube, and then I try to get the piston out. Yeah, but it's not working. Please come out. Nope, it's not coming out. If it comes out. Yeah, it is actually really familiar looking, what I found often in like vintage Phantom Pens. Yeah, this is dry. This is really dry. So there's definitely time for lubrication. And what I use for lubrication is silicone grease. And you may recognize this bottle. And if you have any Wispy pens, you get this really liquidy silicone grease with them. And that's what I use. You can buy this from like Phantom Pen restoration sites and maybe in a hardware store, but make sure it's clear silicone. But I use this, which comes with the Wispy, because I think it's like, yeah, it's good stuff. And I like its liquidity because it's like really easy to apply on the pistons. And about silicone, because it repels water, it's really important that you are getting it on the right place. And not the feet, because if you get that on the feet, it will be like really... How could I show this better? I'm working around my camera. I'm dropping it on the seal itself. Not much, like a little bit of this stuff goes a long way. Too much silicone just ended up clogging your fountain bench because it will end up your feet. You don't want it that there. Usually I try to, if there's like bit space between these seals, there's like two seals, I try to apply silicone grease between them and for the like the backmost seal. Also, I think this rod here can use some silicone too. It really needs some lubrication. It was a bit stiff to work on. And this is really messy stuff, so try not to get it too much on your hands. So. And then I will assemble the pen and hopefully get it right. And I'm going to assemble the way that I screw this piston here all the way. I think that's possible. Try it really gently. This, yep, go there. And it actually, I did it wrong way. I think I will do it like, yeah. Now it's like moving, it's still a bit stiff, but to do it. I'm trying to put it the same place where it was when before I remove it. And then you can see it here that it's like catching up on the threads. And it's catching up the threads here. It's maybe a little bit fiddling here. Like I noticed that I can feel the resistance on the threads, so I know they are not like connecting right. So I rotate this piece until I can feel that threads are like line up and matching, so I can feel like the, yeah, now I can feel this like start to go smoothly. And you can see the piston start to come up. And this gap here starts to close. And what is important here is that this happens simultaneously. So now I can hear, now I can see I have this much left on my piston. Usually it means that I have like thread this back again and then insert this this back plug on the pen, then rotate it and insert piston from front. But actually with this pen I'm pretty sure I just can, yeah, I just can rotate it like shut. And now piston should be working. But please don't like force it if you have vintage pen, because vintage pens may have like some notches that prevent the seal from rotating, or it may be a little bit stiffer. But yeah, now it's well lubricated and it shouldn't be like stucking on the walls anymore. So that was my first fountain pen problem video, like stuck piston. And I hope this was helpful even some way. I tried to keep it really short, but you know me, it's impossible to keep some videos short if they are about fountain pens. So if you have some fountain pen problems, leave the comments below, because I hope this series will be like ongoing and like the common problems, like basic nip problems. I'm not nip master or like tuning nips, but some basic nip problems, basic fundamental problems you encounter. So I can like try to solve them and give some like helpful tips or something. So hope I see you in my other videos as well. Bye.